right, let's see. Let's see. I think... I mean, shit, who do the Tyrants play? The Tyrants... I gotta see who they're playing. Let's simulate through this date. Is there any other... Let's see. Are there any other teams with, like, they're close to a playoff spot? They're fighting? The Ravens are. Who are the Ravens playing? They got a Tyrant, a game coming up against the Tyrants. The Grizzlies. Should we sim a week? All right. Let's sim to April 6th. It's April 6th. See where we're sitting after that. Uh-oh, Ravens, you got to win. Couple injuries. They beat the Sonics. They lose to the Tyrants. The Tyrants won. Matthew Satora, he's healed, ready for the playoffs for the Magic if he makes the playoffs. I don't know if the Magic are there. We got 4 days left of the season. Let's see what's going on. Playoff picture. Jazz, Blazers, Warriors, Kings, Grizzlies, Rockets, Suns. The eighth seed is still open. Three teams battling it out for the one or for the eighth seed, the final seed, the final placement in the West. It's down to these three. The Spurs, the Ravens, and the Clippers. Let's check out the East. Oh my, it's still not over yet. But I think one game. All the Hornets need to do is win one game, and they have locked in the final spot. Tyrants, you got to win out, man. I don't think it's happening. I think the Tyrants are not making the playoffs. It looks like the Hornets are going to be able to hold on. Oh, my God, dude. The West, 8th seed, looking crazy. Ravens. Who do the Ravens play? They don't play any of those teams, though. What about the Clippers? Clippers are also... Or the Spurs. Who do the Spurs play? So none of these teams play each other. Who do the Clippers play? Clippers play the Mavericks. Let's just simulate. Let's just sim. Simulate through the date. Let's see who's going to be our playoff teams to end this season. To the playoffs we go. The Clippers lose. They win. And they lose. They win 1 out of 3. The MVP of the season, Crackhouse of the Detroit Pistons. 15.7 points per game, 6.8 rebounds, 6.1 assists, 1.5 steals, and 1.2 blocks. 54% from the field. 88% from the free throw line and 45% from downtown. Are you kidding me? Crackhouse is ridiculous. Jesus. Rookie of the year, Goldie's mistress. Oh, you know it. Look at it. Look at how good looking she is. What a sexy bitch. 16.4 points per game, 7.6 rebounds, 3.1 assists, 1.2 steals, 1.2 blocks, 60% from the field. Tucker Boner is our sixth man of the year, 13.6 points a game, rebounds 4.1, 4.7 assists, 1.1 steals, 48% from the field and 92% from the free throw line, 43% from downtown. Mike Litteris, Defensive Player of the Year for the Denver Nuggets. 1.6 steals per game and 1.8 blocks per game. Jesus. And Most Improved Player goes to Mike Litteris. Nick Nurse is your Coach of the Year. 53-29 for the Raptors. Whew. Okay, let's advance. Those are our awards. All-NBA first team. Steve Rash from the Clippers. Steven Money from the Warriors. Crackhouse from the Pistons. Goldie's Mistress from the Rockets. And IB Lurkin from the Hornets. Marvin King for the All-NBA second team. Pueblo Escobar. D. Fenestrator. Woozie from the Pacers, and Jimmy Bones. All-NBA third team, Chicken Little, Brody Scott, Daddy Longlegs, Cody Deadzone, and Han Lu. Your all-defensive first team, led by Marsh, Huston Deadzone, Mike Litteris, and Nick Brumfield, and Eaton Hakimi. All-defensive second team, Mark Howden, Ghost Guy, Roland Young, Crackhouse, and Clifford the Big Red Dog. We got the all-rookie first team, Goldie's Mistress, Steve Rash, Daddy Longlegs, Cody Deadzone, and Huston Deadzone. All-rookie second team, Micah Stanley, Jason Eaton, Jeremiah Cherry, Nibby Ruski, and Chase Bank from the Trailblazers. So those are all the all-NBA teams. Here is our playoff picture. Utah, the one seed in the West, going up against the Ravens. The Ravens grab the eighth spot in the West, the final team to get a to get seeded for the playoffs. We got the fourth seed, Sacramento, going up against Memphis. We got Golden State, the three seed, going against Phoenix, the six seed. Portland, the number two seed, up against the former GGBA champions, the Houston Rockets. We got the Raptors, the one seed in the East, going to go up against Charlotte. Atlanta, the fourth seed, up against Washington. Indiana, the three seed, going up against the Mods, the Providence Bees. And the Cleveland Cavaliers, the two seed, going up against the Detroit Pistons. So that is our playoff picture. Now, before we start the playoffs, let's go through and let's look one more time at the conference standings for all teams. Utah Jazz, 52-30. Portland Trailblazers, 49-33. Golden State Warriors, 48-34. 47-35 for the Kings. 45-37 for the Grizz. Suns, 45-37 as well. Dude, three teams were 45-37 in the West. Houston Rockets, 42-40 was good enough for the eighth seed in the West. They won three straight games to end the season. Spurs, 41-41. Clippers, 40-42. 39-43 for the Lakers, or for the Mavericks. Thunder, 37-45. Not bad when they started off the season like 6-30. 35-47, the Streamers. My team. 35-47 for the Lakers. 34-48, T-Wolves. Sonics, 33-49. 31-51 for the Nuggets. 30-52 for the Pels. And that is the worst team in the Western Conference. 22 games back of 500. Eastern Conference, 53-29 for the Raptors. Cleveland, 51-31. Three-game win streak to end the season. Oh, my God. Pacers, 49-33. The Hawks, 48-34. Wizards, 48-34 as well. Bees, 47-35. 47-35 for the Pistons, 43-39 for the Hornets, and that was the eighth seed in the West. Tyrants, losing record, 40-42, 39-43 for the Bulls, Celtics, 39-43, 38-44 for the Heat, Tropics, 36-46, a six-game winning streak to end the season for the Heat, and they still were 15 games back. The Nets, 35-47. 35-47 as well for the Bucks. Sixers, 34-48. 33-49 for the Magic. The Knicks, 33-49. And that was the worst, tied for the worst with the Magic in the as the final team in the East. Damn. So our power rankings going into the playoffs. Raptors, Blazers, Warriors, Cavaliers, Pacers, Hawks, Jazz, Pistons, Wizards, Rockets, Kings, Bees, Grizzlies, Hornets. Damn, look at that. The Clippers are actually ranked higher in the power rankings than the Suns, but the Suns made the playoffs. And so did the Ravens. Oh shit. Alright, season stats. Let's check out the final stats for league leaders. Points per game. We're just going to do like top 10. Actually, yeah, we'll do top 10 and then we'll go through and we'll quickly look at every team's stat line. Nathan King Carter, 18.2. George, Chicken Little, Z the Process. Jeremiah Cherry, Goldie's Mistress, 1A, Horn Dog, Daddy B, and Kent Dwayne are your top scorers. Offensive rebounds, Tickles McElmo, 1A, Cal Drogo, Supton Wong, Clifford, Mike, Jordan, McBoofer, Fat Daddy, and Sweet McMeat. Ivy Lurkin was our defensive rebound per game leader. Goalieman, Supton Wong, Fat Daddy, Roland Young, 1A, Ryan Global, Jimmy Bones, Han Lu, and Tickles McElmo. Rebounds per game. Ivy Lurkin, Goalieman, Supton Wong, 1A, Fat Daddy, Tickles McElmo, Roland Young, Jimmy Bones, Clifford, and Michael Carr, number 10. Michael! You can rebound, but you don't fucking score, apparently. Nobody averaged more than 10 assists a game. 9.9 was the closest. Stephen Money, Steve Rash, Fitzgerald, Scott King, Seafelt, Xavier, Schultz, Dead Zone, and Smoochie. Old Smoochie, the old man. 1.8 steals for Dead Zone was our leader. Golgi's Nips in there, number 8. And Marsh, number 10, 1.5. 2 blocks a game for Global, Kearns, and Goalie Man. They're our best blockers. Fat Daddy Lurkin. Where's... Man, not even in the top 10 for blocks, Beefy. Turnovers per game, Dead Zone, 2.8. Dead Zone, you got to hold on to the ball there, brother. Smooch, you would. Golgi's Nip. All right, field goals made. Goldie's Mistress, 6.7. Field goal percentage, 62%. 62.9, technically. Jesus, quick maths, decimal points. I don't know how to read. Hey, Boofer, you're up here. Beefy, 60% for the whole season. Beefy, I don't know if you made any fucking threes. Three-pointers made, zero. Zero. Chicken Little, 3.1 threes made per game. That was the leader. That's it. On an average of 7 attempts. Shroud's up there with 2.7. A lot of good three-point shooters in there. 52% from three-point land for her boyfriend. Land. Teddy was 51. Lucy Pussy. Are you kidding me, Mini? Your guy's in the top three for three-point percentage? This is bullshit. Dead Zone played for the most minutes. I want to see plus-minus. Wait, points against per game, Dead Zone. Almost 40, he allowed almost 14 points per game against him. You got to play some better defense than that, Mr. Dead Zone. Especially in the playoffs. 4.6 for Richard Sanchez and B-Dash Johnson are our top two for plus-minus. Who's our worst? Immortal Eclipse for the Sonics. Oh my god, almost minus 5. Almost 1,500 points this season for Nathan King Carter. 750 rebounds for Lurkin. 810 assists for Money. 147 steals for Dead Zone. 168 blocks for Global. 232 turnovers for Dead Zone. Mistress made the most field goals. And Process attempted the most field goals. 255 three-pointers made for Chicken Little. He was the leader. He also attempted the most. 320 free throws made for Jeremiah Cherry out of 371 attempts. Dead Zone played the most amount of minutes out of everybody in the league. Most fouls committed, long finger toenails. I wonder why, dude. Stop scratching people. 86 games started. How the fuck you manage that, Jimbo? How you played 86 games, Jimbo? I already checked Beefy making threes. He didn't make any threes. The beard. Mark DeShark, 181 threes. Yeah, maybe he got traded and played a bunch of more games. Bogey's Nip, 177. Darb was in here. DeDarb. Saplington, Dr. Delirious Come Daddy. Marvin King, Bake the Baker, Teddy Swole, Post Malone, Mathers, Daddy B. Stealth is in here, 143 steals, or three-pointers. Barry McCockiner at 6'11", made almost as many threes as Stephen Money. Made more threes than Stephen Money. And Manuel Vega? Vega. Yikes, the worst 99 overall. To be fair, he is a mid-range shooter. He's not a three-ball shooter. Come on, Vega. All right, let's see. Player stats. I'm just going to go through it super quickly. You guys can just look at it. If it's your team, we're starting with the Clippers. So you're looking for your player. If you see your player, you want to look at it for a second, I would just hit pause. If you're watching this on YouTube, I would do the same. Just pause if you see your guys' name. But I'm not going to read them all out because that would take forever. Damn, dude. Did Jelly not get any playing time? There's a couple players who didn't get any playing time, I guess. Maybe they got playing time, but they didn't score. Yeah, I think it would have been 0.1 if he would have made a three. Prodigy, no playing time on at 85 overall, though. We're about to start the playoffs, Mr. Firecrotch. We're just going through the final stats of the season, my dude. Oh, Thighwalker injured. Too bad. Well, I guess it doesn't matter considering the Knicks aren't making the playoffs, so they didn't make the playoffs. Daniel Tye was the leading scorer for the Lakers. Damn, dude. The beef show wasn't very good, huh? Sniper Cat leading the bees, dude. The bees are nasty. Watch the bee. Don't count the bees out, bro. They might fuck shit up. The mod team, bro. To Darb led the tropics, baby. Good job, Darb. Darb's probably not even in here. Teddy Swole, Vega. They tried, man. Teddy tried to bring that team back. Poor Yance down there. The Nets are definitely not a playoff team. If their leading scorer only has 13.8 points per game. And it was Matt Neal, their point guard. He was a 99 overall, though. Something wrong for the Nuggets. Wait, who was Western Conference final team last year? The Lakers? Not this year, bro. Okay, Eddie. I'll believe it when I see it. Nip was absolute garbage this year. I don't know what happened. We made him really good, too. I think it's just because the defenders were so much better this year. Like, everyone was a good defender, you know? Defense was definitely everyone's strong suit. Last season, we had so many, like, 70, 60 overalls that, like, defense was what was lacking. So, there could be one dude that was a good scorer that could just take over, you know? So, it definitely played out a lot different this season. Daddy B averaged 16 points a game for the Suns, man. The Suns. Don't sleep on the Suns, bro. They might make a run in the playoffs. Oh, man, the Thunder. At least they brought their season back a little bit. They had three players average 15-plus points.
No, I don't worry. I'll tell you, I'm a man who believes that I died.
All I can say is Beefy would have won the dunk contest. I mean, you don't even have to jump to dunk, Beefy. That would have been pretty cheap. Don't sleep on the Blazers, bro. That two seed in the West, led by Brick Falco, the 6'5 point guard, shooting guard, all around superstar combo. The Warriors made the playoffs, didn't they? Oh, no, they didn't, did they? What? No, they did. I can't remember. Wizards did, led by Kim Jong-un. Ravens made the playoffs, that final spot in the West. That three-game win streak at the end of the season to seal the deal. Pretty impressive. Led by Eaton. Yo, Steel Sound, King Arden, Scorpion, you be silly. Thank you guys so much for the resubbage, man. I really appreciate you guys. Ah, the Tyrants, they came up short. They came up short. Let's see, Beefy averaged 12.1 points per game. Let's see if you actually made a three, Beefy. Zero, didn't even attempt one. Did put up 17.1 points per game. That's pretty high compared to a lot of these players. I feel like 15 is about the highest I've been seeing. 16. These two put up points. Marvin King, man. For the Cavaliers. Watch out for the Cavs. But Tyler McBuckets, that's right. He's injured. Their second best player is injured right now. That's not good. That is definitely not good going into the playoffs. Oh, God. Shroud was our leading scorer. I was our 14.2 for me. Too bad. So sad, man. Could have been something, streamer team. We could have been something. I feel like I shouldn't have made Shroud my 99 overall. I should have made, like, one of my big guys or something. Dude, Khal Drogo was a beast. All right, we just went in. Did we do all the teams? We started with the Clippers, right? Did we start with the Clippers? I think we did. Okay, I think we went all the way through. So those are the final stats for each player. It's fucking playoff time. Let's do this. Let's get into this shit. All right, what should we do? Round one. So I think we watch one game. Oh, I don't know how to do it. Should we just simulate? Should we simulate all the first games? Simulate day one? And kind of see, like, what games, like, what matchups are getting close? Sim a game at a time? Okay, let's do it. Simulate game. Please note that the following earlier games will be simulated. Oops. I want to do... Let's click daily view. First game is the Pistons and the Cavs. Pistons, Cavs, simulate game. But that's not an earlier game, though. What the fuck? I'm an emperor and you'll surely witness. I'm from Ketha, but I've been in Malkuth doing business, moving vicious, because I see the cycle getting repetitious and plenty of. Oh, that's because that's. Wait, today. Tomorrow. That's the first game. It's Bees Pacers. Well, Wizards have an injury. Their injury. Okay, good. So Pig Majestic is back for the Wizards just in time for the playoffs. Tyler McBuckets is also back for the Cavs for the playoffs. Indiana won game one. View the box score. Oh, the Bees, you lose by one. 26 points for Galactic Gangsta. 6 assists in the win. 5 of 5 from behind the arc. 16 for Custer. Bam Bam, 10.17 boards, dude. Bam Bam fucked y'all up. You couldn't stop the Bam Bam. Bees, 19-7 for Beard. 17-4-5-3 for Stealth and the loss. A 1-point loss for the Bees. Oh. The mods. Zach Immortal, almost 9 rebounds, 10 assists, 3 blocks. Too bad he shot like shit. Could have been the difference. 2 of 9 for Mini. Mini, you suck dick. What's the next game? Wizards, Hawks. Wizards win the 5th seed. Hawks put... Oh, and it was an OT game. 142-141. 26 points for Gwilly. 12 rebounds in the loss. 22-3-8 for Matthew. 17-6-6 for Dipple. Oh, man. So close. But the Wizards, led by Lincoln Burrows, 29-9 with 3 blocks. 22-8-12 for Kim Jong-un. Oh, my God. How did Kimmy get 8 boards? The man's like 5'6". He's 5'11". What a beast. Eden Hakimi, 3 steals, 3 blocks. All right, Daily View, what's the next game? Tomorrow. Today. We got Suns and Warriors up next. Ooh. Suns win! Oh, shit. 116-109. The Suns get the win on the road. Dr. Delirious, come daddy. 18 points, 6 boards, 3 blocks for the Warriors. Pueblo, 15-3-6. 13-7 for Sanchez. 11-13 for Stephen Money in the loss. 19 for Wallace to lead. 17 for DJ back problem. 15-4-9-3 for Marin Fitzgerald and Carmichael. 15-5. Daddy B only had 11, but he had 8 assists. Suns get it done on the road, despite a 19-point third quarter. And the final game of the day is Grizzlies-Kings. Sacramento wins. Is that on the road or is that at home? 106-95. Sac wins. 14 points for Little Dip. 13-8 for Big Bob. 11-5 for Boyfriend. He was 4 of 15. Yikes. But they win anyway. That is not how you want him to shoot. He had the best 3-point percentage in the regular season. He was 0 for 4 from downtown. 16 for Jordames. 14 for Chicken Little and 7 assists in the loss. Grizzlies, man. They only put up 95 in the first game of the playoffs. You got to do better than that. All right. Let's see. Today's done. Maybe we should just... Can we simulate the entire day? I just want to simulate the entire day. Like all the games. We'll do it this way. Is this a good way to do it in chat? We got Pistons and Cavaliers coming up. Pistons, Cavs. That's their first game, right? Pistons, Cavs. I'm Cavs are winning this one. Oh, Pistons grabbed it. Pistons grabbed game one on the road. 129-121. 23-5 for Tyler McBuckets in his first game back after his injury. 17-7-4 for Drogo. 16-4-6-3 for King in the loss. Pistons led by Johnny Sins. He can do it all. 23 points, 19-4-6 for Krackhouse. 17-10. Dude, the MVP is coming for that title, boys. And 14-3-7 for Nathan King Carter. Pistons win game one. Who's up next? Hornets? No. Wait, today, Hornets and Raptors, their first game. Raptors, the one seed, they grab it. 133-129, only a 4-point win for the one seed. 24-8-2-4-2 for Cheeks, 19-9 for Ice, 17 for Rusky in the win for Toronto. 28-9-3-2. Oh, 1A trying his best. Dead zone, 18 points, 15 assists. Jesus, 15 assists and a loss. Hornets dropped game one. Who's up next? Is it Portland, Houston, I assume? Portland and Houston up next. Portland grabs game one. 138-123, a pretty easy win. 15-point win at home. 25-7 for Falco, 25-6 for Woods. The two guards put up big numbers. A double-double for Viking. And the Blazers roll. 19 for Mark DeShark, the former MVP. Blazers take game one against the former GGBA champs. All right, the one seed and the Ravens. Can the Ravens take game one? No, the Jazz. They win. Motzko, 29 points. 6 boards, 4 assists, 12 of 14. They win by 10. 19-10 for Golgi's Nip in the win. 19 for Thought, 17-8 for Lester. Damn. Jeez, the Jazz played well. 20 points for Eaton, 17 for Knott, 14, 6, and 5 for Bobby Biracial. Reigning champs, technically. All right. So after game one for everybody, this is where we sit. Let's head up to game two. Wait, if I click simulate round, nah, we'll do it this way. This is just the best way to see each individual game. So today is done. Tomorrow, Bees and Pacers. Game two for them. They tied it. The mods, they tied it in game two. 123-119. Brody Scott, 24-10, double-double. 19 for Saturday off the bench. 15 for Galactic Gangsta. And the Pacers drop game two. 23-8-2 with 3 blocks for the Lucy Pussy. Marsh, 14 points, 14-6 for Stealth with 3 assists, 2 steals, 3 blocks. Judge Judy added 12 points. And the Bees get it done on the road in game two. Is it this? Is this the next game? Yeah, Wizards Atlanta. Wizards, 2-0 series lead to start the playoffs. They take game two, 132-114. Both of those wins on the road. 18-5 for Matthew. 16-3 for Gwilly. The Hawks, man. How are they losing? At home? 27-5-5-3 for Kimmy J. Oh, my Lord. The little general. Breeze added 17-10, double-double. And the Wizards starting to get it done on the road. Cartman added 15 boards. All right, what are we doing next? Is it Golden State Phoenix? It is Golden State Phoenix. Phoenix has already got a one-game lead, and they take a two-game lead. Are you kidding me? The Suns? 136-131. Pueblo, 23-8, 21-5 for Come Daddy, 20-9 for Money, but it's not enough. They lose again on at home. 17-6-2 for Phil Ennis to lead. That's off the bench. 16-11 for Marin. Daddy B, 16-9. 15 for DJ Back Problem. 15 for Wallace. And it's a great team effort. 53 assists for the Suns. Kings and Memphis. Just want to double check. That's make sure that's the game it is. Kings and Memphis. Simulate. Sacramento. They take a 2-0 series lead. 119-117. It was a close one. Boyfriend, 19-10. 18 for Pecor. 17-9 for CJ White. 15-7 for Little Dip. Damn, Sacramento. 20-7 for Ruben. 15-5 for Jordames. And a double-double for Holy Fuck. But it's no good. Grizzlies fallen. Down, and now they got to go to Memphis to win some games. All right, so what is it now? Cleveland, Detroit? It is. Game two for Cleveland and Detroit. Cleveland ties it, the 2 seed. They tie up the series. Mantis Toboggan leading the way. 21 points, 14 for Cheeto. 13-5-11-3 for Marvin King. Khal Drogo with a double-double and 3 blocks. Pistons, led by Daigle, 19-7, 18-2-5 for Crackhouse, 14 for Sea Anals, And Fat Daddy 8-10, 3-3 in the loss. Nathan King. Oh, Johnny Sins 2-10. He was their leading scorer in game one. Nathan King Carter 2-7. Pistons scorers didn't show up in this one, man. Atlanta and Washington. No, is that no? No, it's Toronto and Charlotte for their game two. Charlotte, they got a win against the one seed. Oh, they tie up the series. They get a win on the road. Oh, they fucking crushed them. A 30-point win in game two for the Hornets. 18 for Rusky, 16-6 for Cheeks, 15 for Trubisky. And the Raptors get rocked. 38-7-3 for 1A. He fucking annihilated them. 15-7-8 for Lurkin. Are you kidding me? The Hornets crushed them. That's ridiculous. 1A just went off. All right, Portland and Houston. Their game two. Simulate. Portland wins. They got a 2-0 series lead. They win by 4 over the reigning champs. 25 points, 6 assists, 2 steals, 3 blocks for Falco. 19-5-5. Falco and Woods just dominating. Leading the team again to a victory. Blazers looking real nasty in the West. 26 for Mark the Shark in the loss. The former MVP trying to do everything to lead his squad. But it's not enough. And they fall. Now they're headed to Houston. Hopefully they can win at home. Utah, Vancouver. Ravens need this win. They don't. Utah, 2-0 series lead. 125-108. It was easy. Brown, 8-19 points, 17 for Golgi's Nip, 6 assists, 3 steals, 14 for Flux in the win. 25 points for Knott in 28 minutes for the Ravens. McMeat, 13-8-10. Coxlong had 14. Bobby Biracial with the double-double, but it's not enough. Oh, the Jazz, man, they're kind of rolling through them. All right, we're on to game 3 of Cleveland-Detroit. Oh no, Pacers at B's first. Oops. Indiana wins. Game 3 goes to Indiana. It's a 2-1 series lead. It was a 3-point win on the road for the Pacers. 28 points for Sniper Cat in the loss. 22-4-7 for Marsh. The mods fall. Despite 48 assists as a team, how many assists did the Pacers have? 46. Led by Gangsta, 27-5. 19 for Bam Bam. 7 boards, 3 steals, and 2 blocks. Flick to being 17-7. Pacers get it done on the road. Mods trail. Atlanta, Washington. Washington with a chance to take a 3-0 series lead. They do. The 5 seed takes a 3-0 series lead over Atlanta. Led by C. Rorch, 23-6, 20-6 for Kim Jong-un. It was a 135-121 victory. Wizards trying to go for the sweep. Matthew, 24.6 assists, 18-6-7 for Dipple, 14 for Gwilly. Uh-oh, Hawks need to figure it out. All right, Phoenix. Can Phoenix take a 3-0 series lead over the 3 seed? They don't. Golden State answers. They get the win on the road, 120-118. Daddy B, 18 points, 17-5-4 for DJ Back Problem, 17-6 for Wallace. The Warriors answer, though. 20 points for Come Daddy in the win, 17-9 for Pueblo, and a double-double for Steven Money. All right, Warriors holding on. They're not done yet. Sacramento and Memphis, can the Kings get a 3-0 series lead to start? Memphis answers. They get the win at home. 110-97. Holy fuck. 19 points, 5 assists. 15 for Yoda off the bench. 5 of 8 from behind the arc for Yoda. Beast mode. Kings were led by Big Bob, 19-6. 16-5 for Pecor. DD Bravantis, 10 points, 6 boards. Kings fall. All right, so what are we up to next? What's the next game? Daily View, getting a little mixed up. Today. Is that everything for today? Yeah, that was. Okay, the next game, Cavs-Pistons. Cavs Pistons. Game three. Detroit wins. The seventh seed takes a 2-1 series lead over the two seed. And it was a dominating win. 24 points. Johnny Sins puts up another huge game at home. 32 points in the win. 17, 3, 6, and 3 for crack. And Nathan King Carter added 14 points. Fat Daddy had 5 blocks. Nepo, 15 assists. Cavaliers, 23, 5, and 4 for Mantis. Where the hell is... Where's your leading scorer? What happened to Marvin King? 2 points, 6 assists, 1 of 8 from the field in the loss. He didn't show up. Marvin. Oh, no. Cavs drop game 3. Toronto, Charlotte. Can Charlotte take a lead over the 1 seed? They do! The Hornets win game 3! 130, another 30-point win for the Hornets. That's back-to-back ass-whoopings. What the hell? 23, 11, and 7 for IB Lurkin. 22 and 10 for 1A, the double-double. 19 and 3 for Mute. Oh my God, what is going on? 16 for Ruski. He was our leading scorer in 9 assists, 15 and 9 for Cheeks. What is going on with the Raptors, dude? They can't figure it out. They're getting wrecked. Portland and Houston, game 3. Portland, 3-0 series lead over the reigning champs. What is going on with Houston? Krusek, 17 to lead the Rockets. 14 and 9 for Golgi's Mistress. 13 and 12 for Franklin. Mark DeShark, 3 of 12 in the loss. Just a great team win. 3 players with 17 plus points for the Trailblazers. They win by 1. To be fair, it was close. It was close. It was a 1-point win on the road for Portland. Came down to the wire. And Utah, Vancouver. Vancouver needs a win. They don't. Utah, 3-0 series lead for the 1 seed. They are dominating. 128-118 the final. Sweet McMeat, 18-6. 17-11 for Bobby. 13-9 for Eaton. But the Ravens just can't find an answer for the 1 seed Jazz. Golgi's Nip, 24.7 assists with his new squad. He's trying to... He left the Lakers to play for the Jazz, and now they're a 1 seed and they're making a run for the championship. Golgi's Nip might have found his home. 21-7 for Mo Lester Jr. Flux had 16, 13-5 for Damon Motzko. Nip is still trash. You think so, Beefy? You think so, huh? I don't know about that. You better take him and lace him. All right, game 4 for Indiana and the Bees. 2-1 series lead for the Pacers. They take a 3-1 lead over the Mods. Uh-oh. Stealth puts up 26 points in the loss. 139-123, the final. 18 for Marsh, 15 for Sniper Cat, and nearly a triple-double for Immortal in the loss. Brody Scott puts up 30 and 11. 22 for Woozy. 21 and 7 for Flick the Bean. 15 for Saturday and a double-double for Mr. Custa. 50 assists for the Pacers in the win on the road. Damn, dude. They outscored the Bees by 16 in the final quarter. Uh-oh, Mods. Uh-oh. I kind of want to watch this next game for the Bees. I want to see him potentially lose. Atlanta Wizards. The Wizards going for the sweep. Can Atlanta hold on? Can they keep their season alive? They do! They win game 4. Their season staying alive. Woo! Getting a little crazy there for the Hawks. Let's check out the box score. 125-112. They win on the road. 18 for Breeze. 17 for Alphon. Cardman 15-6-4. Kimmy J was just letting them have a game. Gentlemen sweep. 26-5-5 for Han Lu in the win. Do or die. Matthew 18 points. 17-7 for LaSousa with 3 steals. All right, we got Phoenix Golden State. Can Phoenix take a 3-1 series lead over the 3 seed? They do.
Phoenix is coming for them.
113-107, Phoenix wins. Led by Marin Fitzgerald, 17 points. 13-6-7 for Daddy B, couple blocks. 13 for Mao Ying. The Bees are looking, or the Suns are looking good. Henriquez, 18-2. 16-8 for Sanchez, 14-4-8 for Pueblo. Come Daddy, only 9 points on 4 of 12. Not what you want from the 99 overall, Dr. Delirious Come Daddy. 15 assists for Steven Money. He's trying. Sacramento and Memphis. Can Memphis tie up the series? They don't. The Kings take a 3-1 series lead. Finger toenails in the loss. 26-7 with 5 blocks. 16-12 for Chicken Little. 126-108 the final. 17-9 for Pecor. 15-7 for Boyfriend. 14-3 for Millwood. 3 other players with 10 plus points. And the Kings get it done on the road. All right. Cleveland, Detroit. Can Cleveland tie this series up? They do. We got a 2-2 series between the Pistons and the Cavaliers. Johnny Sins puts up 17 points in the 7-point loss. 110-103. Daigle had 17-16 for Nathan King Carter. Krackhouse 9-10, 7-3-2. 12 assists for Nipo Yaskalopes. 18 for Ming Rhee, 18 for McBuckets, and 17-7 for Giants Bane. Kyle Drogo added 14-8. Double-double for Mantis Toboggan. All right. Can Charlotte, the 8 seed, take a 3-1 series lead over the 1 seed Toronto Raptors? They do! What is going on with the Raptors? They won game 1. They've lost 3 straight. And it was a 1-point overtime win for the Hornets. Oh my God. Dead zone, 21 points, 7 assists, 4 steals, 18-6 for Sangster. 1A with a double-double. Lurkin, 12-13-6. I mean, this team is just playing so well. Hornets come, they came back in the fourth and then win it in OT. What a game by the Hornets. 24 for Fig, 8 rebounds, 3 assists in the loss for the Raptors, 18-12 for Cheeks, and a double-double from Matty Ice. Damn, dude, this is getting crazy. All right, let's see. We've got, what's next? What's the next game? Is it this? Is it Golden State and Phoenix? No, it's Trailblazers at Rockets. What am I doing? Portland Rockets going for the, Portland's going for the sweep against the reigning champs. Can Houston hold on? Can Houston keep their season alive? No, the Rockets have been swept. The Rockets have been completely swept. 4-0, Portland advances. Oh, look at the box score. 152 in regulation to 134. Fork puts up 24 points, 23 for Franklin. Mark DeShark doesn't show up again. Mark, you're the best player on the team. The champs can't make it back. They get swept. 29 points for Kenny Powers. Look at his numbers. 10 of 11 from the field. 23 for Keen, 17 for B-Rad. Jesus, the Blazers roll. No competition. I'm losing my voice, chat. All right. Can Utah do the same thing? Can Vancouver keep their season alive? No, the Ravens have been eliminated. They've been swept. So the Jazz and the Blazers both sweep. 123-116. Knott puts up 21 points in the loss. 17-7 for Bobby Biracial. And the Ravens fall. 17 for Ghost Guy in the win for the Jazz. Funyuns 17, 13 for Thought. I mean, Golgi's Nip only had to put up 12 points, 8 assists, and his team still wins? Good win by the Jazz. With you.